Hi everyone, this is Veronica. Today we are going to talk about eAUSHADHI portal. So what is this eAUSHADHI portal? Let me tell you, AUSHADHI in Hindi, it means a medicine. So it will be a portal basically for the Indian medicine system. So we'll discuss in detail about this eAUSHADHI portal. For my video updates, you can follow me on Instagram and Facebook. So this is our channel StudyIQ. If you're preparing for any government exam, our pen drive and tablet courses are also available. For additional information, you can call on these numbers or you can visit our website too. The PDF of this lecture will be available on our website and it is available in both the languages, Hindi and English. So now what is the relevance of this topic from your exam point of view? In your mains paper 2, governance, it will be covered under this particular topics, especially under social sector services relating to health. And at objective level, what is this AYUSHADHI portal? What are the main features? And at subjective level, what is the need of promoting AYUSH system of medicines in the country? Now let's see what are the main features of this eAUSHADHI portal. So first it is... it comes under which ministry? That is important. Ministry of AYUSH. We'll discuss in detail about AYUSH also. Ministry of AYUSH has launched eAUSHADHI portal, and this is for online licensing of Ayurveda, Siddha, Yunani and Homeopathy drugs. So this is very important. Online license will be given to the people who are whether consumers, manufacturers and producers. So this portal is intended for increased transparency. So transparency can be increased related to the drugs of AYUSH department. Improved information management will be there, improved data usability and increased accountability. For example, why this was important? Because if you need a herbal drug or if you need a homeopathic drug and you did not have a proper information about it, like which company you should go for. So such things will be increased through this portal. They will be transparent and more information will be provided. So basically, AYUSHADHI, it is an acronym for Ayurveda, Yunani, Siddha and Homeopathy Automated Drug Help Initiative. So AYUSHADHI is an acronym and you should remember the full form also. And this portal is obviously licensing the authority and manufacturers and consumers, and it will also provide real-time information of which are the actually credible manufacturers and their products. So the spurious drugs cannot come into the market. Contact details of authority will be given in case you find some spurious drug in the market or some drug which is not credible, right? So basically the manufacturers, if they want to go for this license, it will be very easy process through this e-portal. Timelines will be fixed for processing of application through this portal, and the manufacturers can track their status also through email or SMS. So overall, it is an endorsing step for the AYUSH department, for the AYUSH system or the Indian system of medicines. So here now we'll discuss about what are these Indian system of medicine. So see, India has recognized 6 systems of medicines till now. It is Ayurveda, Siddha, Yunani, Yoga, Naturopathy and Homeopathy. So the Ministry of AYUSH, the AYUSH is obviously for these systems like Ayurveda, Yoga, Naturopathy, Yunani, Siddha and Homeopathy. It was formed on 9th November 2014. So they formed this ministry to ensure the optimal development and propagation of AYUSH systems of healthcare. Earlier it was known as Department of Indian System of Medicine and Homeopathy, and we used to write as ISM and H, which was created in March 95, and it was renamed as Department of AYUSH in November 2003 with the focused attention of development of education and research in Ayurveda, that we want to enhance the research and development in Ayurveda, Yoga, Naturopathy, Yunani, Siddha and Homeopathy. So now we'll discuss what are these systems. So firstly, we would like to talk about Yunani system of medicine. So see, Yunani system originated in Greece and its foundation was laid by Hippocrates. However, the system owes its present form to the Arabs, who not only saved much of the Greek literature by rendering it into Arabic, but they also enriched this medicine of their day with their own contributions. Now next is Ayurveda. So this word Ayurveda has derived out of fusion of two separate words. Here Ayu means life, okay, and Veda means knowledge. Thus, in literal meaning, Ayurveda is a science of life. So, it aims to keep structural and functional entities in a state of equilibrium, which signifies good health, that is a good swasthya in Hindi we call it, through various procedures, regimen, diet, medicines and behavior and change. So that is how Ayurveda works. Now Siddha system. See, Siddha system of medicine is practiced in some part of South India, especially in the state of Tamil Nadu. So this term Siddha has come from Siddhi, which means achievement. So, Siddhars were the men who achieved supreme knowledge in the field of medicine, yoga or tapa. Tapa is meditation. Now, next we'll come to Saurikpa. So, Saurikpa, it is commonly known as Tibetan system of medicine. It is one of the oldest living and well-documented medical tradition of the world, and it has been originated in Tibet and popularly practiced in India, Nepal, Bhutan, Mongolia and Russia. So, the majority of theory and practice of Saurikpa is very much similar to Ayurveda. Now, Saurikpa is based on the principle that bodies of all the living beings and non-living objects of the universe are composed of five cosmophysical elements, and these were Prithvi, that means earth, Jal, that means water, Agni, that means fire, Vayu means air, Akash means sky. So when the proportion of these elements is an imbalance in our body, disorder results. So this is what Saurikpa says, and it was recognized by the government of India in 2011. Now let's come to homeopathy. See, the word homeopathy, it is derived from two Greek words. Homeos means similar and pathos means suffering. It was introduced in 18th century. Homeopathy simply means treating diseases with remedies that are prescribed in minute doses, which are capable of producing symptoms similar to the disease when taken by the healthy people. So basically, it is a holistic approach towards a sick individual through promotion of inner balance at mental, emotional, spiritual and physical levels. Now, let's talk about what are the challenges in the AYUSH system that the people are facing. See, the ability of Ayurveda, yoga and naturopathy, that is AYUSH practitioners, to cross practice, the highlighting current restrictions on allopathic practitioners from practicing higher levels of caregiving, right? So, however, these debates miss the reality, which is a primary health system that is struggling with a below par national physician patient ratio, that is 0.76 per 1000 patients. That is very low, among us the lowest in the world, due to paucity, because the MBBS trained primary care physicians and the unwillingness of existing MBBS trained physicians to serve remote rural populations of India. So urban rural disparities in physician availability in the face of an increasing burden of chronic diseases make healthcare in India both inequitable and expensive. Now, quality standards of medicine, scientific validation of AYUSH has not progressed in spite of dedicated expenditure in the past. And there's lack of human resources also, because practitioners are moving away from the traditional system for better opportunities. And even the existing infrastructure is remaining underutilized. It is not utilized properly, because the fourth common review mission report of 2010 of the National Health Mission report, the utilization of AYUSH physicians as medical officers in primary health centers, that are PHCs, especially this report came from the Assam, Chhattisgarh, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh and Uttarakhand. So they said that human resource as a rationalization strategy, there is a lack of human resources also. And in some cases, they noted that while the supply of AYUSH physicians was high, a lack of appropriate training in allopathic drug dispensation was a deterrent to their utilization in primary care setting. So what is the way forward? That they should be made to do a bridge course, so that they can also cross practice, they can also write the allopathic medicines for the patients in the rural areas, right? So what could be here? We can talk about the way forward also. What is the way forward? See, the capacity building of the licensed AYUSH practitioner through bridge training that I just told you to meet India's primary care needs is only one of the multi-pronged efforts. And there's an urgent need for trained cadre to provide accessible primary care services that cover minor ailments, health promotion services, risk screening for early diseases detection, and appropriate referral linkages, and ensure that people receive care at a community level when they need it. This is some of the way forward. Rest, what are the challenges I have discussed? So you can also write or tell me in the comment box what is the way forward for the challenges AYUSH system is facing in India. So this is all about today's lecture about AYUSH. So if you have any queries, you can mail me, you can contact me in anywhere on the social media. Thank you.